family, talking about my brothers and me.
I haven't got time for a second.
Billy boy.
Joe, that's the other guy that beat me up.
Well, hi, honey.
Just watch your mouth, buddy.
Oh, she's got a temper.
I'm warning you.
No, I'm warning you. You even exhale on me, and you're in trouble. My father's the chief of police. My only regret is I didn't work you over a little more the other night.
Did you hear that?
I certainly did. Young man, you have just confessed in public to a crime. So in legal terms, you're screwed.
Captain, engineering reports icebergs trying to turn north. No one knows what's causing it.
Probably some deep ocean current. All engines ahead 2/3.
All engines ahead 2/3, aye. Sir, we're not controlling the berg. The thing's trying to tow us. The cables are starting to overstrain.
All engines ahead full.
All engines ahead full, aye.
Bridge, number 4 cable station, strain gauge moving into red line.
Bridge, aye. Captain?
All engines ahead flank.
All engines ahead flank.
Make a hard to Sabo.
Bridge, cables into overstrain.
Get clear now.
Move!
Captain, gauges are redlining.
All engines stop.
All engines stop, aye.
Knock on our door.
Come and knock on our door.
We've been waiting for you.
We've been waiting for you.
Excuse me. You alone?
No.
Mind if I join you?
I'm already attached.
Come on, Blondie, give me a break, huh?
You heard the lady, pal. Shove off.
Okay.
So, ladies, step right up. My time has come.
You know, when I arranged this meeting with your publisher, I knew I'd be lunching with one beautiful woman. Never imagined there'd be two. Well, here's to Women's Life and its very lovely delegates.
Oh, thank you. Mimsy felt Susan should be here since she is in charge of the new supplement, and as I understand it, that's where most of your advertising will be concentrated.
Well, that's where the action is, and where the action is, Lollipop is.
To Lollipop Jeans, may our association be a long and profitable one.
Cheers. Mm. You know, Elaine, I've been an admirer of your magazine for some time. I found it sensitive to the needs of its readers and forward-thinking.
Oh, you can certainly say that about Woman's Life.
I'll say. I can just look across the table at Susan and know all I need to know.
Susan?
Me?
Of course. Assigning a bright young girl like Susan is an example of that forward thinking I'm talking about. A woman like her has her fingers on the pulse of this country.
Well, I do try to keep on top of things.
She can feel what's happening and where it's happening.
Must be painful.
Now, what I'd like to do is get your impressions on our current ad campaign. Did you get that layout we sent you?
Yes. No. Oh, Mimsy sent me a copy, I assume.
Well, obviously an oversight. Oh.
That's no problem. Susan, what did you think of it?
I loved it.
Great.
I loved it. The first page was terrific, where the 2,000 kids are standing in the field with jeans.
Good.
And I loved the second page, where they're all lying down and they form the American flag.
I only wish Betsy Ross were here to see it.
Now, we're thinking of continuing that American theme next month. Picture a young Whistler's mother in Lollipop jeans.
What an interesting concept.
You know, it's nice to work with someone your own age. Another drink?
I'll have a glass of warm milk.
Happy birthday!
Oh, Susan, thanks.
Hi.
Oh, Alan Thackeray, meet Michael Sampson.
Hi, Alan.
Nice to meet you. Come on in.
Thank you.
Help yourself. There's food on the table and there are drinks in the kitchen.
Oh, thanks, Alan. Here, this is for you.
Oh, thanks very much.
And this is from me.
Oh, thanks again, Susan.
Come on, Susan. Let's get...
It's Soap Opera Review with Fred Holliday, Andrea Howard, Cameron Young, and from New York, Susan Buhrman.
Our investigative reporter Cameron Young visited with Lee and filed this report from behind the scenes.
Thomas Wolfe said, "You can't go home again," but I'm talking with a young lady today who's broken that rule. Lee, I thought you died.
No. Lee did not die. Sally may have died 7 years ago, but apparently they're going to get around that. She's come back to life somehow.
Pretend it didn't happen.
Yes.
Do you enjoy playing a character like Sally? Does that come easy to you? Is it close to yourself?
No, it's not close to me. I hope it's not close to me. Sally was kind of dumb, and I think I'm somewhat intelligent. She just sort of gets in her own way, and... it's hard because she's basically kind of a self-destructive person. Mm-hmm. And to get into that mental frame of mind every day, or every day that you're working, it's taxing.
Mm-hmm.
So.
So what's Sally up to? Is she going to turn Genoa City upside down? Or?
Probably. I don't know. We're kept not knowing what's going to happen. I know a week ahead of time what the shows are going to be, and that's it. Maybe they might give you a basic storyline, but... other than that, it's pretty much mystery.
Huh. Lee, I want to thank you for talking with us today. It's been fun.
You're welcome.
With lovely Lee Crawford and a neighboring weed eater, this is Cameron Young.
Different strokes it takes. Different strokes it takes. Different strokes.
Hello?
This the Drummond residence?
Yes, it is. Can I help you?
We're looking for Arnold Jackson, 697 Park Avenue, Earth.
Hey, did you find my rocket?
No, but we have a pretty good idea of where it is. He'll tell you.
Oh, that's great news. Please, come in, gentlemen.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Where's Herman?
This little one must be Sam McKinney.
Excuse me. May I ask who you gentlemen are?
Yes, ma'am. I'm Jenkins. That's... Armstrong, State Department.
State Department? Hey, NASA must have heard I'm a pretty good scientist and sent the big boys down to pick my brain.
Not quite.
Is there some kind of a problem?
Some kind. It seems that Arnold's rocket crashed through the window of the Soviet delegation to the United Nations. See, folks, the rocket crashed through a skylight during the middle of a big staff dinner. It landed between the borscht and the chicken Kiev. They called the fire department, who in turn called the bomb squad, and the entire building had to be evacuated.
It was great. We got pictures of every one of them racing out of the building. Sure beats hanging around gangster funerals. I mean, you can just spend out. I'm done.
Bottom line here, the Russians are pretty upset.
Oh, great. Not only am I going to flunk science, but now the Russians are after me.
Arnold, I think you're exaggerating.
Maggie, your face is not going to be hanging in every Russian post office.
Stop complaining, Arnold. They've already got Herman. I'll bet he's probably halfway to Moscow. I just hope he's wearing a fur hat.
You better hope he isn't a fur hat.
Forgive me, everybody, but I think this is just plain silly. After all, this rocket ship was just a child's school project.
Rest assured, Mr. Drummond, we're convinced that Arnold isn't trying to overthrow any foreign governments.
Oh, of course he isn't. Arnold gave that up years ago. Look, why can't you just go to the Soviets, explain to them what happened, Ask them, please, to accept our sincerest apology for any inconvenience we may have caused them. And could they please possibly return the spaceship and the mouse?
And if that doesn't work, I say storm the embassy.
I'm sure there'll be no problem. These people must have a sense of humor.
When's the last time a Russian made you laugh?
Not since Khrushchev.
We do have a snag, ma'am. Boys, I'm sorry, we have some bad news.
Yes, the Russians won't return the rocket or the mouse. They're pretty miffed about the whole thing.
They got over the Cuban Missile Crisis. They'll get over this, too.
I hope so, ma'am. But you see, the camera that Arnold hid in the rocket got them to thinking about spying.
Spying? I don't believe that. That's ridiculous. Arnold, you didn't put a camera in the rocket ship.
And another thing. The mouse got them to thinking about germ warfare.
Germ warfare? Now, that is absurd.
Maybe not, Mr. D. Herman did have a cold. Mr. Jenkins, you've just got to get Herman back. You've just got to.
I'm very sorry, Sam, but the... They're shipping everything back to Russia. They're going to inspect the camera and examine the mouse.
Why? You two and the State Department are going to stand around and let this happen to my son's mouse? I don't...
Maggie, please calm down.
Well, Philip, do something.
Mr. D, do something. You can't let him hurt Herman.
Gentlemen, I think that they're right. Something should be done. If you're not going to do it, I am. It's just outrageous hanging on to a child's toy and a pet. I'm going to go down there and give them a piece of my mind.
And if that doesn't work, I'll give them a backside full of buckshot.
Mr. Drummond, Mrs. Drummond, the United States State Department would frown on that.
We frown on a great deal.
Well, it just doesn't make any sense.
I'm sorry, sir. We can go back and make some more phone calls, but I don't think it's going to change anything.
Well, we understand.
We do. I don't.
I wish things could have worked out better.
It's days like this I wish I were a fireman.
I wish you were, too.
Mr. Drummond, Arnold, right on time.
Everything is set. You'll be meeting a Mr. Dushenko. That's his aide right there.
We'll be right outside if you need us.
Thank you.
Don't go too far. I guess you can keep in touch with headquarters.
Headquarters? I'm listening to the Knicks and Lakers. They're in overtime.
No, really, it looks good.
Really?
Yeah.
I missed these, and I'm having a hard time seeing without my glasses. You had to do the eyebrows, too.
Yeah, we did. Good to see you again, Stephen. Oh, they didn't have to bleach the eyebrows. Listen, that was nice work, Stephen. We've been waiting a long time to get something on Dolan. You're a brave man.
Really? Then why am I so scared?
You don't have to worry about a thing. Our witness protection program has a 100% success rate. From this moment on, all traces of your past life have been erased.
You have a completely new identity.
Well, in a way, this couldn't come at a better time because my building is going condo.
Listen, why don't we start with your new identity? Dave, why don't you give him the documents?
Right, here we are. Checkbook. We have Social Security card, driver's license.
Donald? How can you give me a name like Donald? That's a duck's name.
I'm sorry.
Donald Smith?
Well, actually, we were toying with Duckman. Just kidding. Your FBI has a sense of humor.
At 874 for Albuquerque.
As long as we got each other.
That's 12 more cents right in my pocket.
Excuse me, you carry the Thunderclap 2 system?
Yeah, we got it.
And?
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. It's been a long day. Yes, we do carry the Thunderclap 2 system, and I'd be happy to
to have Richard here demonstrate it for you. Could you please show this gentleman the Thunderclap 2 system?
Oh, that's expensive.
Right this way, sir.
Michael, it's almost closing time.
Yeah, I know, Jerry. Just give him a minute. He's about to move the highest priced system in the store.
You're right. It is this way.
Come on, just for old time's sake, all right? I mean, he's your buddy, too.
It's a time for buddies, and there's a time for business.
I can't thank you enough.
Hey, tell a friend.
Boy, that was quick. Well, we'd be happy to help you load your components into your car for you,
sir. Nah, I can wait. The bone here tipped me that the Thunderclap 2 is going to be on sale next week. I'll wait till then.
Hey, see you then, Maurice.
Hey.
We did it, hon.
Yeah.
Look at that view, huh? Pure, unspoiled.
What unpolluted beauty. The only trouble with being up this high is really hard to get your breath.
Well, hiking this high altitude cuts down your wind.
That was a girl, right?
Thought maybe I was hallucinating from woman deprivation.
That's Hal's room.
His sister, maybe?
No. Her I know.
Bye-bye, Hal. I'll see you soon. Hi, Betty. He's all ready for you.
Nobody's that good.
I can't stand it!
It's just that some guys got it and some guys don't.
Friends?
All right, I confess, Your Honor. They're my readers.
Hey, readers?
Yeah. Well, you guys know how much reading we have.
Oh.
And believe me, it takes a lot longer to read with your fingers than with your eyes. So I'm on a new regime. I'm skipping classes to concentrate on the reading. That means those girls will be coming and going 13 hours a day.
13 hours? Every day?
Every day, those girls will be coming and going through these portals. I trust this won't inconvenience any of you.
Oh, no.
Yeah, but 500 guys a week are dying over there. If they really do cancel student deferments.
I wonder if Nixon's got a chance.
Nixon? Bobby Kennedy's gonna win it. We'll put a stop to this whole mess.
Hey, Krentz, one of your readers just called. She can't make it on account of the snowstorm.
What am I gonna do? All my readers have canceled out, and I've already lost 2 days' work.
Hey, relax. She's sending a substitute.
Well, guys, this is it.
Okay. Asner, Anier? Okay, Walker.
Yay.
Fletcher. Jones, Daniel.
Daniel A or Daniel E?
A.
A, that's me! Oh,